I'm sitting here with Freek van der Knaap, who is the Vice President of Gourmet Western Europe. And he's really the man behind the World Chocolate Masters. Is that right?
That's, of course, that can't be right because it's a team effort. But it's true that we have a lot of customers and participants in the contest coming from Western Europe, but it's definitely shared with all the regions. So we've got our Asian colleagues, our US colleagues, our South American colleagues, Eastern European colleagues. So it's really a team effort.
It's a big event. What does it mean for the company, the World Chocolate Masters?
It's very important to us. I think what we really want to achieve with the World Chocolate Masters is four things, of which maybe two might sound might be obvious, and two maybe are a little bit less obvious. The first two things that I think you would expect that they are the reasons why we are doing this are that we want to really excite our customers, we want to excite consumers with the possibilities of chocolate. Secondly, what we also want to do is excel. I mean, after all, it's the World Championships. We want the best of the best, and we want the best of the best to win. It is a competition, and we want people to see that and to feel it. And I think it's obvious from today that that is actually happening. And then there's also two reasons why we are doing it that maybe are less obvious to the outside world, but internally we use a lot of it. The first reason is that we want to innovate. We think that innovation is the lifeblood of our business. It's also very important for our brands. And what you see here today is really cutting edge. It's leading edge. The chefs that we have here, the artisans that we have here, really are pushing the boundaries of chocolate. And they give us a lot of inspiration that we can take home and also use in our efforts to innovate. And the second, or the fourth actually, but the second last least obvious reason is that we want to motivate. We want to motivate young professionals that being an artisanal pastry chef or being a chocolatier has a future in itself. And that's really a very inspiring profession to choose.
Well, we have seen a lot of excitement today, a lot of emotion, a lot of tension, a lot of excellence. And I must say, I saw in the Q bar today, I saw a couple of candidates who participated in 2009 and in 2007. We also have some in the jury. So is it true that it has really played, or it plays an important role in their professional lives, this event?
Yeah, I think you can say without exaggeration that it really is the case. You have to remember that before entering this competition, before showing up here in Paris, they have spent at least 2 years preparing for it. The first year basically is their choice to enter the competition, and they do that through local pre-selections that we organize in these 20 countries. If they want to excel at that and win the local World Chocolate Masters title, then they have to spend a serious amount of time in it. But then it only starts, because once they've won their local competition, then and they get their ticket to the finals here in Paris, actually a year of intense training starts. We try to help them by by supporting them by making it possible for them to have world-class experts helping them improve their performance. But it starts and ends with their effort and their passion. So they spend numerous evenings, weekends, away from their family, away from their jobs, to get perfection and then to show up here. So I think it's absolutely right that it makes a lasting impression in their lives, even if they don't win. And that's also one of the spirits that we want to bring here. Even if you don't win, it'll be a big event and you will learn a lot from it. And it should give you a platform to grow into the future. And if you see today who are here with us from previous editions, we've got Hirai-san from the honorary president, who was the winner in 2009. We've got Ragnarsson Haflidi, who has done and worked with us in previous occasions, and I think he entered in 2005. So it shows that once you've had this experience, we stay close and they are really bonds for a lifetime.
Well, last question, you're into chocolate the whole day long. What is your favorite?
Of course, I have to give a smart answer on this, because and you've asked me before to prepare, so I could. So I give you my rational answer, but also it's an emotional answer. My kids, they love A23, Calabout A23. Whenever I open it, they eat it out of my hands. Yesterday, again, I saw the power of the Cacao Barry Lacté Caramel. It's a variety that once you open it, the caramel chocolatey flavors and scents, when they come to your nose, they just motivate you to eat more. But the best is maybe yet to come, because next year we will bring a limited edition chocolate ambassador chocolate coming from a specific plantation in the rainforest of Brazil. And we were so lucky this year to visit that plantation with our customers, with our ambassadors. And we were actually picking the cocoa pods, the beans ourselves from the trees in the jungle. And we will use that for to come out next year with a real limited edition chocolate. So I think that will be the best experience.
When did you do that?
This was in May this year. Yeah. We had a fantastic trip taking about 120 of our dear ambassadors from all over the world to Brazil and visiting Origin Plantation.
That must have been a great experience. Thank you very much. And then, another exciting day on Friday. Huh? Thank you.